Hello, good morning, it's me. Today, me and Amanda have decided that we're going for a walk, but it's raining, so we had to bring umbrellas. Amanda's has raindrops on it, which means it's functioning correctly, I think. And mine is a rainbow one. I really like this umbrella, I love the colours, it's so pretty. But, because it's a day off work, the first thing I have to go and do is get this hair sorted, because I have lots of it. And I need to work out what to do with this weird, like, I have, like, proper male receding hairline, which looks, let me tell you, super sexy. But we need to work out how to hairstyle it. Also, I'm going to get my beard trimmed right down. I am a mess. I'm going to go not be a mess. So let's go do that first. Ba-da! There we go, new haircut. Look at that. I am looking sharp. I look damn sexy, in my own opinion. But I love me, so... We're off for our walk now. We're by the river. Amanda's umbrella. Amanda, give your umbrella a twirl. Okay, stop lowering it. Perfect, perfect. Beautiful, I love it. So Amanda's umbrella goes multicoloured in the rain, which is good, because that's when you're likely to have an umbrella. Mine's multicoloured all the time. So going for a walk down the river, going to go look at some nature, do some walk, get rained on a whole bunch, and then... I don't know what the end part of the plan is, actually, now that I think about it. We'll find out when we get there. We made a swan friend. Hello, swan friend. Goodbye, swan friend. Oh, hello, swan friend number two. Just floating by us now, we have one of Peterborough's man-made islands. Magnificent. Okay, so there's this cool little public footpath that goes down here, and in the summer, I will probably show you what it is, but I'm not going down there in the mud. Not in these shoes, they're too white. I love you all, but I don't love you enough to get my white shoes all muddy. Sorry. This is actually quite a nice, serene place to take a walk. Well done. Not 100% sure who I'm congratulating there, so that one's up for grabs. So if you need a well done, you take that one. This is, quite possibly, the least informative sign I've ever seen. Okay, now, I don't claim to be a tree biologist, but there's something not right with this tree. I'm just not sure what it is. I've been comparing it to a couple of the other trees in the area, and I think what's wrong with it is that it doesn't have any leaves. Or a bird's nest. So it's missing two fundamental things from being a tree. So here we have a very nice and slightly far away heron. Truly the heron of the bird world. But do you know where the heron got its name? So, the heron is the rare Pokemon of the bird world in England. You'd see them sometimes. I mean, you might see them a lot, depending if you live near somewhere that has a lot of them. But I don't tend to see a lot of them, so to me they're rare. So what used to happen in England years and years ago was people would seek out rare things like herons, and they would keep them as pets and such. One day, some rich guy who had a heron as a pet was asked by some not rich guy who did not have a heron as a pet, "Excuse me, mate, what's that?" And the guy simply replied, "Ah, he Ron," because he had named his heron Ron. I think that's where the name comes from anyway. I might be wrong, there might be some historical inaccuracies. Caution, many Jack facts may not in fact be facts. This is Peterborough City's rowing lake, okay? So can you see these little like red ball thingies that are in there? So what these are, is these are little miniature naval mines, okay? So this will stop rival like rowing clubs coming and using this place to practice, which I think is a pretty nifty idea. Because what you can do, you can invite the like enemy team. Rival team. You can invite the rival team to come and practice on your rowing lake and be like, "No, it's fine. No, those just divide the lanes. No, no, they're not dangerous at all." And then they start practicing and kaboom! No more rivals, no more enemies, gone forever. And a dead opponent is an opponent that's finishing in last place. My glasses are getting very wet. Private water. Underwater cables. No swimming. No fish. Not 100% sure how they're planning on banning fish from their water, because that's where fish are, you know? Fish can't be anywhere else. Water's like their thing. You can't take that from them. That's cruel. Come on, Peterborough Rowing Club. Get your act together and stop drowning fish on land. Welcome to Neen Park. For parking, cycling, rowing, and crucifixions? Stop. Look. Listen. Beware of trains. Cyclists, dismount. That's the weirdest poem I've ever read. Peterborough actually has its own little steam railway. Oh, I just hooked my umbrella on this fence. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. I can't really show you because it's a weekday, and it only really runs at the weekends. So... this was entirely a pointless 10-second set of clips. Here you go, there's a poster. Just imagine like that there. Okay, so there, but with that on it. Okay, this, but with there. I like that 97% of this is entirely stinging nettles. It's beautiful. And also, this is one tree. Actually, there's loads of trees. I don't know why I pointed at that one tree in particular. You're all beautiful. We reached the apex of our walk, and we're now on the way back. I've been and had my hair cut and my beard tidied up, and now I've just gotten wet, and now I'm a mess again. So, you know, at least you've seen me slowly devolve back into this through the course of this video, so I have documentary proof that it's real. Really, all that's left on this walk now is the back of a supermarket and then, like, the field next to our house. So nothing particularly interesting that you haven't seen before. So I'm going to call the vlog here, and I will see you in the next one. Now watch as I let go of this umbrella and hope it doesn't fall down so I can do the outro high five.